let's do, so I'm trying not to just make it a bunch of theory. Is that satisfactory? Clear? Okay. That was so funny. And anyway, so behind the nut, again, on the telly thing, it's a really deep dish. And I like this guitar because to me, it seems to have a little deeper dish.
Yeah, this is supposed to be just like a 53 neck. I think this is not as deep as that.
Yeah, this one goes pretty deep, right?
It's not real.
But anyway, it's a nice deep dish. It's not mandatory. And the other thing I liked about this one, and I had a signature guitar made by Fender a couple of years back, there's like nothing here. And I really like that. Like, yeah, the ears is pretty good too. Like sometimes there's like a thing here. You know, I guess if there's some luthiers here, they might have a better word than
flute.
Thing. What's it called?
Flute.
A flute. That's why I hang out with Luca. He knows a lot of stuff. And anyway, so you guys know what I mean. Well, this, my hand goes really comfortably. And the first behind the nut bend I did was just this. And I was really proud of myself. Instead of, you know, that leg we all know, right?
A7, B7, and B, you know, and
I try and incorporate that stuff, and I like that the telly makes that easy. So, yeah.
Are you pushing straight down or bending it up at all?
Well, it's just, it's, so from behind the nut, I'm pushing a D up to E.
But you're pushing down, not?
Down, yeah. Okay. And that actually helps me remember something, and I don't know if you guys are like, you know, but I hope not. But you got to move back. Like when I show this to people, they put their finger by the nut, and that really hurts. You got to go here. And everybody, you know, a lot of people I teach want to do this, and it really limits you. Like, you know, like when you reach back, it's way better if you're not here. It's like you have to go way farther in distance. So use your first finger is my point, just your first finger. But I wouldn't start on the D string, because it does hurt. And, I mean, if I'm on the beach and stuff, people are kicking sand on me all the time, you know. But as far as my first finger goes, it's like, man, it's a he-man. So, you know, and it took a while to get there, you know. And that's a good way to do it, half step bend. And, you know, you get some control, and you'll just feel what a bend is. And then maybe go for the whole step, and then your finger will hurt so bad you'll want to quit and come back in a week, you know. And it took me about 3 times. You know, everything really takes me 3 times.
What gauge of strength do you use?
9s. I could do it on 10s, and I would actually prefer to use 10s. But, you know, I just don't want to get tendonitis. And, you know, I'm fine, but, you know, maybe for 20 years I've said, you know, I wish I didn't have a D'Addario endorsement. I wish I had an Advil endorsement. you know, because my hands swell up or they hurt. And I don't know about you, Luca, like, but most of the guys, do you have hand problems at all?
They're coming.
Yeah. I mean, everybody has them and nobody talks about them. So, but you know, God, there's guys like, you know, that play 12s or Stevie Ray Vaughan did, you know, I mean, I don't know, but everybody I know, and not just guys my age, like, I mean, getting there, like once you hit 40, 35 even, it's like, but they all, if you do have hand problems, I mean, mine have always passed. You know, there was one point where I couldn't move my first finger for, geez, it was almost a year. Like I really had, but it made my technique better. And I just still play, you know. So that's why I don't make the move to 10s. But I like 10s because I like the sound of 9s better. And I get a pretty big sound from 9s because I just put the amp on 10 and get a lot of bass. But
does that mean the top loader maybe?
Probably, yeah. I mean, I don't notice that. Like I said, my hands are pretty strong. Like, I mean, sometimes just to make a point, like if there's 11s, I'll do. But I think it would lead to, you know, like that's up to G sharp. I could get A. You know, it's hard to get to A, but that's whatever it is, a 42. You know, so and I do that went out. There it is. So, but I do use 9s, and so. Yeah, and you want to be, there was like, I guess that was, there was another point I wanted to make. Oh yeah, the reason I like 10s or 11s is it's easier on the right hand, because there's more of a surface to pick. Sometimes this does feel like a bit of a little thread, you know, like. Would be easier if it was a 10 instead of or an 11 than a 9. So anyway, let's just play a little song and I'll try, you know, when you think about something and you say, oh yeah, you know, it's behind the nut, and, you know, and then there's these volume swells and all this stuff, you know, you try and force it and you end up like playing kind of bad, but I'll chance that. And
sorry, I mean, it seems obvious, but like, I think you have a great idea of the tune right now. You start sometimes with the back of the string actually like bent already.
What is that?
Or do you always?
wondering if you ever do that.
Yeah, I mean, and that's, yeah, I'll bend, you know, because I have a feel for what it is. And that's with this little exercise. Actually, I put it on my website, this little exercise. Then we'll do the little tune. It's just this. I know it's just a C scale, right? But I swear this is like the best exercise. And just, you're in fifth position. Get it.